So guys, I forgot to add this to the previous video I did. Jeff at 1.02, Tama at 0.83, Nelson at 0.70. So this was how you guys voted last week. Hello, ni hao, my fellow BB Ninjaga. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Susan and I'll be posting recaps of Big Brother Ninja Season 4. Hashtag PepeDemGang. You don't want to miss all the spicy Atarodo jits, so I beg, just subscribe and turn on the post notification. Thank you.
Tasha.
That's not very smart.
So apparently Tasha has been called all kinds of names because of this guy Ebuka broke this table. Hey Jesus. And BB Ninja, Tasha, Dumb, characteristics, you know, they've been trending on Twitter and Instagram and everything because of the table Ebuka broke. Okay guys, I'm just gonna read all through what really happened. So in case of those people that did not really know what happened, I'm just gonna give you guys the real gist and the full gist.
Three characteristics of what a Big Brother winner should have.
Tasha.
That's not very smart.
So guys, here's my question before I head into the video. Was Ebuka just intentionally being shady at Tasha, or was he just trying to like show to the world or show people that Biggie is not really doing everything in Tasha's favor? Or do you think Tasha was just intentionally on her own part trying to be proud to accept the fact that she does not really understand what characteristics is or the definition of characteristics? Let me know in the comment section, guys. So guys, the moment Ebuka got to the TV, like the TV screen in the house, the first person he talked to was Shayi, and I guess because they've been evicted, fake eviction and all of that, and then he moved on to Tasha straight away. And then, okay, let me just read everything that happened, okay? I'm just gonna read it because I can't really show you guys like the full clip of the video to avoid copyright. So Ebuka said, "You sort of have crowned yourself the resident Big Brother expert in the house. You know what's trending, you know who's gonna win, you know what matters in the game. So I want you to help me out. Give me three characteristics of Big Brother, of what a Big Brother, give me three characteristics of what Big Brother winner should have." And Tasha said, okay. So I think someone was talking there. She said, "Calm down now." Then Tasha now said, she lifted her hands and said, Tasha.
Tasha.
Then Ebuka said, "That's not very smart. I did not say, like, he did not say name. He said characteristics."
That's not very smart.
Then Tasha said, "Me characteristics, Ebuka." Then Ebuka asked her, "Are you a characteristic?" Before I keep myself name. "Are you a characteristic?" Then she said, "Yes." Then Ebuka said, "You are a characteristic." She said, "Yes" again. Ebuka said, "Okay, define characteristic." Then Tasha just laughed. Then she now asked again, "What defines a winner?" Then Ebuka said, "Characteristics of winners of Big Brother. What do you think the person should possess?" Then Tasha said, "Ebuka, first off, I have not, like, she has never said anything out there about anything, like, she has not been out there saying anything about being a winner or something. I guess that was what she was trying to say." Then Ebuka said, no, you know everything that's trending, you know who's gonna win, so what do you think the winner has to make them win?" Then she said, "Me." Then Ebuka asked her, "Are you acting ignorant, like you don't know what I'm talking about?" Then she said, "I am not acting like I don't know what you're talking about, because she's obviously here to win." Oh god. And then Ebuka asked her again, "Tell me, what does the winner have? What does the winner possess?" And she said, "Anything I possess." Then Ebuka asked, "Which is?" She said, "Me" again, and she laughed. Then Ebuka was like, "I expected better, but unfortunately I don't know," and he moved on to Mercy. So, Tunde Ednot, we all know this guy is something else in, he's not even in Nigeria, but we all know this guy is something else. He said we should not call him a blogger, but Tunde, anyone Tunde does not like, he makes it open. And once he does not like someone, because of the giveaway and all of that that he always gives to people, his fans, his followers, people that are on his page, they are going to come for you no matter what, because they think he's going to favor them. But then again, really, I know Tasha is very confident, but then, guys, on my part, I expected something else from her. I expected her to say something else, but probably I'm not supporting her. Neither am I going to bash her. I just feel she was just on a hot spot, and there was no possible answer that could come to her head. The same way Shayi was on a hot spot, and there was no possible person he could have picked than picking himself and putting himself up for eviction. And also, don't get me wrong, guys. Don't get me wrong. I'm not supporting her. I'm not saying she's dumb. Neither am I saying she's smart for answering that way. But honestly, let's just be honest here. I don't want to say something that people will come back at me. And I don't want to say something that I'm going to contradict myself. But people, let me just know what you guys think in the comment section. Because at this point, yeah, If you've been following me from day one, you would know that I've been rooting for Tasha no matter what she has been doing in the house. She has been annoying, she has been doing all sort of nonsense in the house that even me myself, Muabungazi, I can't stand it. But at the same point, if you are rooting for someone, no matter what the person does, you try as much as possible to understand the person. And whenever the person does something that is not making sense, you make it clear that yes, at this point, baby girl, you are not making any sense. And that is why if you watch few of my videos, you see me, you know, sometimes I just say that yeah, she's doing the most or she's doing this and that, but still the way people are coming for this girl, it's too much, guys. Meanwhile, when Ebuka was asking this question, the housemates were just there like, Jesus, Tasha is doing Tasha again. Okay, let us just watch today. Like, none of them could even move or do anything. They were just looking at her. None of them was even smiling except Ike. Like, seriously. Anyways, moving on, then at this game, I think it's the head of us game or veto power game, and none of them could win the tag, so in that sense, they're not going to be safe and replace power this week. So there we have it, guys. That is it for this video. I really don't have much to say. Like I said before, I'm not going to say anything anymore. So just to avoid being bashed, because I can't even handle it, honestly. Ebuka broke the table already. People are bashing Ebuka for being so unprofessional, for intentionally trying to come at her. And people are also saying, what's her name? Tasha is dumb. That all she knows how to do is just to open body and to do this and do that and to show nipples and to do this and to fight and do that. But then again, it is what it is. Let me know in the comment section, what do you guys think? Do you think Ebuka was intentionally being shady? Or do you think Tasha was just intentionally on her own path with so much pride, trying to cover up the fact that she does not understand what characteristics means? Let me know in the comment section. Anyways, as you guys know, in case you don't know, now you should know, I'm just here to spill the spicy gist. Okay. So there we have it, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you do, give it a thumbs up, subscribe. I don't know why I feel like laughing, but yeah. Subscribe and join the family, join the Suzy gang. We are the best. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Always remember to love what you do. Love what you do and do what you love. Be yourself, love yourself, and believe in yourself. I'm not gonna record this. This is the way I'm gonna leave it here. Thank you so much. My name is Susan Annie and I am signing out. Okay, you go be now. Bye bye.